One of our students asked us about how to actually format currencies in Flash. So we're going to give an answer and we're going to base it on a class that was introduced in Flash Player 10.1 and up. So as long as you're building an application that's going to be working on a Flash Player 10.1 or up, then you're golden. So let's look at it. The currency formatter is really simple and very easy and actually really fun to work with. I think Adobe really did a great job on it. So let's look at it. It's very, very simple. The first thing, I'm just going to create a new variable. I'm going to call it CF for currency formatter, and I'm going to create a new currency formatter. The new currency formatter is going to expect only one parameter, and that one parameter, and this is the part that gets really, really cool. So that one parameter is actually the language which you want it to be formatted into, and the region or the country. Now, there's a lot of different codes, and they're not listed really anywhere, but the format works this way. The first two letters are lowercase, and that's the language acronym. So for example, I'm going to try to do it for Hebrew in the country of Israel. So I'm going to type HE for Hebrew, then underscore, and then I'm going to type in uppercase the two letters that represent the country, which I know those two letters are IL, which is Israel. US is USA, FR is France, and so on and so forth. So all you have to do is you just have to know that specific format that you're aiming towards. Now, after you create it, all that's left for you is really to start formatting, and it's really, really, really simple. So I'm just going to do a little trace, CF, and then I could just type your format and just send a number, any number. Let's say we'll type here a nice big number, and we're going to run our trace, and we're going to see that now we're going to get our currency. It's going to tell us that it's ILS, which is the Israeli shekel. And you have your all this beautiful number, which is exactly the Israeli format. Now, if I wanted to format, for example, to the French version, so I could type your FR for French, and then FR for the French country, and we would have then the euro, which is the currency in France, and we're going to see how it's separated exactly the way it's separated in France. Or let's say if we wanted to do French, but in Canada, so CA, but we're staying in French. And then we have here the number for the French people, and let's see if the English-speaking Canadians have the same format, which I'm assuming they do. Well, they don't. So the format is completely different in the English-speaking side of Canada. Very, very cool. All right, so you can see here all the really, really beautiful, very, very easy to work with, and it just takes care of all the thinking for you, and you don't have to worry about the exact format in the specific country. Now, just a few more words is, why is this inside of the globalization package, which is really, really cool? This is part of the concept of this class of saying that you might be able to build the same exact application and just deploy it into different countries. And the only thing you would really have to change would be the different acronyms that would actually say to what country you're actually deploying your application. So for example, if you're thinking about currency formatter and you want to see if there's anything else but that, you could always look into that Flash globalization and just see what other classes are there. And there's quite a lot of classes that are related to different formatting in different regions, such as date and time formatter, and so on and so forth. So just go explore. And obviously, if you're building a multi-language or a multi-country application that's going to go global, this is going to be a really, really useful class. Now, unfortunately, there isn't any built-in formatter class currently in Flash that isn't dependent on a Flash player build. But there's a lot of open source projects out there that do the simple solution, because it's not that complicated to build something like this on your own. So I do encourage you even to build one on your own, because it'll give you more flexibility in case you have to build out to versions of Flash that are older. Or for our members, we'll probably create a class just for them so they could download and they don't have to create it themselves if they don't want to.